Hello everyone, it's good to be with us again. My name is Benjamin from the Eco Farms and Agro Services Company. In our first series on how to grow maize like a pro, we talked extensively on some of the protocols that are hindering our youth potentials as farmers and as a country. Of course, maize is one of our major staple crops, having nearly seven and a half of our 8 families out of every 10 eating maize or maize related products. So maize is one of the key crops that is helping us to ensure we have a food security in Nigeria. And so when farmers are not producing enough maize, we have a problem. And when we have to import, to depend on imports for maize, we also have a problem. One of our greatest concerns as an organization is how we can work with smallholder farmers to guarantee the safe production of sufficient high quality and affordable maize for the exploding and expanding Nigerian population. And so in today's series, we're also continuing on that topic, but today we have a different topic. The topic is on soil test and how it's a game changer for farmers, helping them to understand their soil nutrient management, preparing the precise and consistent soil nutrient that they need for a bumper harvest. And so what's soil test and why should I as a farmer even think about testing my soil? What's important about testing my soil? Where can I test my soil? These are some of the things we'll be talking about. Stay tuned. The Eco Farms, one of the key things we recommend to farmers is for them to look into their soil. Why would anyone want to put money on the ground when they do not know what the potentials that ground holds for them? I like to liken it to a situation where people are sick and are suspecting certain symptoms. Say you have fever-related symptoms. Headache, you're feeling feverish, and you just assume you have malaria, which is a common ailment around. And then you go to a pharmacy and pay good money for drugs for malaria. And then you go treat that malaria for a number of times and you're not getting any better. Only for you to now go to the hospital at that point and begin to spend more money to discover that you had typhoid all the while, not malaria. And what you may not also know is that because you were treating the wrong disease or infection, you may have contributed to why certain strains of parasites or microorganisms that are pathogenic develop resistance to certain drugs. And so it's important that what you do properly when you feel you are sick or not well, it's go to a lab or a hospital who will direct you to a lab. And that lab is able to pinpoint accurately that this is what is wrong with you based on this information. And then the doctors are able to prescribe precise treatment, precise dosage, and right timing for the treatment for you to take care of the challenge you may be having. That's what happens when we continue to lump our fields with farm inputs, urea essentially, and compound fertilizers like the NPKs. When we do not know precisely what's wrong with our soil. You're farming every year, you're not getting the yields you need, but you feel all you need to do is up your input deposit in the field. You may have certain nutrients deposit in the soil at high volumes, but you may not have some essential nutrients. So it's important that you look into your soil. So we encourage farmers to begin to learn the habit, particularly medium to large scale farmers, even smallholder farmers who are the major individuals feeding our populations. Look into your soil, identify your soil nutrient. What is lacking? What do I need to opt? What do I need to step down? What is not completely there that I need to introduce entirely? And so at the Eco Farms, we provide these services to farmers, detailing soil tests for them, providing a comprehensive soil nutrient analysis for them. And the results from this analysis, farmers are able to use them to interpret and develop. We work with farmers to develop a detailed soil nutrient protocol that will help them to manage better yields in their field. And so just take us through some of the protocols should I want to perform a soil nutrient test for my field. And so maize farmers, particularly maize crops, are high feeder crops, high input dependent, particularly if they are hybrid crops. And you're growing them on the same field year in year out via monoculture. It's important that you you look into your soil and know what is consistent and what you need to continue to manage and build. We used to tell farmers at the Eco Farms that soil nutrient management is a consistent and progressive protocol. It's not a one-off where you come to the field during rainy season, dump all the nutrients you want in the field, and then look for a bumper harvest. What you should do is build upon each year's harvest, see what is lacking, see what you need to invest in the soil so that over time your soil is optimum and optimized for a better yield. So when you need to conduct a comprehensive soil nutrient test, what we recommend minimum for a hectare is 3 to 4 samples per hectare. You require the material to write to identify the size of your land, to identify the hectare you're taking your sample from. You need a nylon bag that even as simple as a pouch like the one we used to make moimoi, or the simple Ziploc bags, or the bags that we used to ripe fufu amala. You need that material, your writing material. While you're in the field, for example, if farmer A has 5 hectares and is looking to do a comprehensive soil nutrient analysis for his 5 hectares, what he requires is to go to that field, identify his boundaries, and walk through a zigzag across each of his hectares, taking a minimum of 3 to 4 samples. So if farmer A decides to take 3 samples from his 5 hectare plants, that will be 3 by 5, totaling 15 samples. And so in hectare A or hectare 1, you are taking 3 samples. So you have your writing materials labeled sample 1, hectare A, or sample A, hectare 1. And then you catalog them through the process. You take your first sample with sample 1, hectare A. You put it in the labeled, clearly labeled sample for that. You have sample 2, hectare A, and you label it. You put it in the same bag containing hectare 1 samples. And you have sample 3, hectare A. So you have your sample 1, sample 2, sample 3, or sample 4 as the case may be, all labeled separately, contained in one bag or pouch, labeled as hectare A. And so within your hectare A, you have your same, your 3 samples or 4 samples. And then you repeat walking through a zigzag. Why a zigzag? Because you want to randomize your sample collection. You don't want to collect your samples from the same place so that it's uniform. You want to touch different regions of that hectare, ensuring that every part of the hectare has different samples collected. These samples are then collected across repeatedly the 5 hectares, or per the case or scenario, and then sent minimum between 48 hours to our lab. And then we are able to look at these samples, and within a period of 7 to 14 days, give you a result that can guide you. What we have experienced looking at soil samples across Nigeria is that Nigerian soils are highly acidic. It's largely from the dependence and excessive use of nitrogen fertilizers. Of course, sometimes from the agricultural practice of bush burning, letting lands fallow during dry seasons, leaving them bare with no cover crops. We found out that Nigerian soils have very low to no organic matter. Even some soils we call virgin lands, they are completely depleted of this key organic matter. The nitrogen to carbon ratios are terribly low. We've also importantly observed that key soil nutrients, importantly micronutrients, as well as even macronutrients, are highly lacking or not evenly distributed. So you can have a farmer who is farming in two regions, or two neighbors who are farming in two regions. One is on a slope, one is on a hill. And the man on the slope, when it rains, nutrient is washed from the soil on the hill to him, and the man on the hill is not able to manage his field properly, so his soil nutrient is poor. An aspect of the soil test, after you have identified your size of land, is the depth to collect your soil sample from. This information is important, but varies across different crops. If you're growing conventional cash crops like maize, vegetables, rice, cereal crops, your soil depth shouldn't go more than 5 cm to 10 cm, because these crops, their roots do not go more than that depth. And so by the time you scratch your conventional hole on the ground, the depth you are picking your soil from is sufficient. But if you are doing tree crops, economic crops, some trees can send their roots several meters deep. And so your soil samples for an economic tree collection will not be same for growing cash crops like maize. It has to be nothing less than 10 to 15 cm, because that's the zone where your young tree will start its root from and begin to sink it down. So it's important that you know the depth you're collecting your soil samples from. It's also important that you study the terrain of your environment. If your field is not very leveled, if you have different or large fields, terrains across your field, say you have valleys, you have hills, you have rivers, you have drainages going through them, you have gullies, it's important that your soil sample collections touch on all these regions. You have a forest, like a riparian forest. It's important that you take your samples across this field so that your samples are evenly spread and your results are fairly accurate. We encourage you to look into your soil before you cultivate. When you have looked at the right seeds, you've decided on the best seeds to grow, you've sorted through them, done your due diligence to identify the right varieties to grow per your indigenous or local agro zone, then the key thing you need to begin to look at is the soil test. Can I tell if my soil is fertile? I had so yields last year, 3-4 tons per hectare. Can I opt it? If I need to opt it, what are the necessary inputs I need to put? The soil test is able to guide you and help you to make that informed decision. Thank you for tuning in. We will continue this series and see you soon. Hello, farmers. It's always beautiful to be with us. Thank you for tuning into our channel. At the Echo Farms and Agro Services Company, we are always excited to bring in contents that are designed to help you overcome common challenges you may be facing in your farm. These contents are designed to help you overcome these challenges. They are real-time, hands-on experience. We encourage you to please share our contents with farmers who you may know will need these contents. Please don't also forget to like. Share your concerns also in our comment section so that we can tailor contents that will meet your specific need. Thank you for tuning in and take care.